So we're in Bristol this evening. We've got a full house of 13,500 in here at the county ground, the home of Grace and Hammond. Between 50 over and T20 cricket.
Ooh!
Maharaj starts with a dot ball, and you get the feeling tonight that those dot balls might be quite precious. Ooh, just a flick of the wrists. Very, very fast hands through the ball there. This is a terrific start from Butler. A second six for him, the first off Maharaj, whipped through mid-wicket. Goes again in the air. This is a tough catch. And that is an excellent take. A fantastic catch, running backwards from the captain, David Miller.
The ball from the pod, it went well above our roof. So I was just watching David Miller, and he did. He circled a couple of times. He turned and he just didn't even focus on the ball at times. Sprinted and then eventually set himself.
Just, just hang on a minute,
as
Sean.
I was saying, yeah.
Oh, he's struggling here. This is a beautiful slower ball that has ended up in the hands of Klassen at backward point. And the moment that came off the bat, Jason Roy knew he was done for.
He managed to pop one in the air and then he's making his way off the ground before the catch has been taken. Good change of pace, 73 miles per hour. The other two deliveries in the over, 86, 85. It does for Jason Roy. He unfortunately has to depart for eight of the fifth.
Does go leg side, goes into the gap, all the way for six. Lovely way for Bairstow and England to end the seventh, 59 for two. Powered away this time from Milan. Another six. Hit hard, sounded sweet. I think the fielder lost it. I think the fielder lost it because he sort of bailed out the last minute and it went over the fence at catchable height.
Hit him straight in the chest. Hit hard and flat from Bairstow. He comes running in as the back pedal and just there loses it. Loses it. Oh, how big a miss is that going to be?
We're looking for a lot better now. Milan goes up and over extra cover. Oh, it's on the full. That's a fabulous shot. The fielder, Maharaj, has signalled to the on-field umpire, David Milnes, that it's six, but... goes again, this time deliberately lifts it high and handsomely into the crowd. Excellent batting from Johnny Bairstow from one over and four balls.
That's a huge drag down. Bit of a pie, actually. Bairstow tucks into it. He's not going to miss out on something like that, even if it is to the long side. Just stands and admires. Another six. Well done, young man.
Good arm.
Oh, that's gone miles. That's gone a long, long way. Not only did Milan have a bit of width, it was a slower ball and it was short, and it's been deposited into the crowd. Got him. He gets his man and he is absolutely delighted. It was the pace on option. Pace on wide of off stump.
And Giddy's excited as well. He would have been questioning what the possible game plan could be because Milan had dictated terms, but he's gone for the seam up, quicker delivery, 79.
There's that short ball. And there it goes. Not too tricky for Moeen Ali, and that's a magnificent grab in the crowd.
Yep.
50 for Johnny Bairstow.
And straight he goes into the crowd. Flat, hard, another six. At tall bowlers. As Bairstow pummels another into the leg side, to the short side. That is a big hit. And he starts this 17th over with a six. What are you saying to your bowlers, Owen? Oh, that sounded sweet. And my, that is a big hit. That's gone all the way over the back of the stand and into the car park. And Bairstow starts with a brace of sixes. And this time, Moeen Ali goes with the sweetest of cover drives over extra cover for six. It's another excellent slower ball, and Moeen Ali is through the shot, but has edged it through to the wicketkeeper, Quinton de Kock. He just walks off, really, he doesn't wait.
Excellent bowling, using all his experience here from Ngidi. Slow, wide. Ali through the shot. But the damage is done. Outstanding innings from Moeen Ali. Everybody on their feet here.
That's an excellent Yorker, speared in to about leg stump.
Okay, it's pitched outside leg. David, stand by. You're on screen. Single now.
Yep, going well down the leg side. Yep, it's out. I wondered whether Bairstow, had he missed that, might have tried to scamper through to get on strike. He's 90, remember. What a roar there would be should he manage to do that. That was another slow ball from Ngidi. And another edge. Oh, it's gone high. It's gone very high, but it's not far enough. And this time, Riley Russo takes the catch, a tumbling catch. A good one in the end. Figures of 5 for 39. He's got one ball left. This was his fifth wicket, with Riley Russo coming in from the deep as he did previously. And in the end, settled himself and took a good catch. But 5 for 39 in the context of what we've seen. Excellent figures for Ngidi. And another wonderful exhibition from Bairstow. Well, in the context of what we've seen, a rather tame end there from Chris Jordan. A leg by finishes it, and Ngidi finishes with figures of 5 for 39.
Double figures from the start. Got him. There were three men placed in the cover region, just as there were at Old Trafford in the one-day series.
It's between South Africa's out cricket and England's tonight, indeed, if there is one. England have made a good start because that was hit firmly, albeit straight, at about waist height.
In the air, third man comes in. Gleeson takes the catch.
And it's a huge first over for the huge man. That is Rhys Topley. Excellent running catch from Gleeson. Big trouble here.
Yeah, vital wickets again with the new ball for Rhys Topley this summer. Gleeson just had to stoop that very stiff back of his that has had a number of fractures. Wow.
Clipped away. It's beaten Adil Rashid at short fine leg and will trickle into the boundary for four. Is your required rate.
Well, Risa Hendricks gets one away. He's missed time three attempted drives.
And that's helped on its way. That's another quality shot. That's over the grandstand.
Miles per hour. Hendricks moving to 41 from 21. It's one of the biggest sixes of the night. Really is very still when he strikes the ball.
It actually wasn't a bad length, was it? And Lahn was somewhere near off stump, but it was just helped on its way beautifully by Hendricks. This is going to be out. Jordan's got safe hands and he grabs it. The timing wasn't there from Klaassen. And a quality over ends up with a wicket.
Excellent reintroduction for Adil Rashid. Certainly missed him in T20s this summer. Chris Jordan does not drop catches like that. Yes.
Coming back for the second, this could be tight. He launches himself and should make his ground comfortably. Butler doesn't seem overly excited.
Okay, I'm ready with my decision.
Comfortably home in the end. Dragged away, that will be one bounce to the boundary. Was the variation, the cutter. And that brings up a 50, a wonderful 50 for Riza Hendricks.
Struck the ball beautifully, taking initiative. The back end of the power play to take on England's most experienced bowler in Chris Jordan. Since then, he's found the boundary.
Goes for the slog sweep. He hasn't got anywhere near it. Sam Curran sets himself and takes it easily. So the decision to go to Moeen Ali might have been influenced by David Miller being at the crease, but he's done the trick and picked up the man who's established himself.
Excellent here from England skipper. Going with spin and matchups. Gets the in man in Hendricks. Young Sam Curran making no mistake with a catch. England get the big wicket.
Was it going to worry England?
Chris Jordan will not catch that. He's got a tremendous pair of hands, but he won't get there because it's sailed over his head. Brings up the 100, 101 for four. That sounded better and has gone a lot further. Back-to-back maximums. Talking about head, did that gentleman get hit on the screen? Hope he's all right. Or was he just scratching his head in bewilderment?
I think he's okay. Hope he's all right. But I think that did indeed land straight on top of the dome. What a strike from Stubbs.
Striking down the ground again. Another maximum, that's a fantastic strike to end the 12th. 22 from the over, boy did South Africa need that, 115 for four. Into the pitch, didn't sound so good as the last one, but it's still gone for another six, his fourth.
Power of these players.
And he does exactly what Mark Butcher has suggested, and that has gone miles. I think that has hit the roof. Gotcha. Towards Jordan, brilliant catch. He is one of, if not the best, I have ever seen.
But he can feel close to the bat off his own bowling. Miller doesn't really get this, but it has a bit of fade on it. Just starts to swing away from Chris Jordan as he picks up the line and he picks up the arc of the ball. Changes direction.
Not quite hit it. This could be the end. It is. It's the end of Stubbs. It's the end of South Africa. Jason Roy taking a good low catch at long off, and that ends a wonderful effort. 28 balls. He gave everybody a thrill.
Yeah, timing just not meeting what it was required at that stage, but nothing to...
That is a fast straight ball from Richard Gleeson, who after a couple of expensive overs is enjoying the 19th with a couple of wickets.
Short 45, Kefisa Rabada, not much cricket behind his name in the recent past, and wouldn't have had too many net sessions, trying to smash that one straight back past Gleeson.
And he does so with a full toss that is helped gently into the hands of Adil Rashid at square leg. So Petlakwayo's innings is completed, 22 from 16, South Africa 7 down. Well, a splendidly entertaining evening comes to a conclusion. England have run out easy winners in the end. 41 runs is the margin.